Okay, here we go, part two. What are we on here?
And I do that because this makes sense for the horse. They understand this. Horses in nature never walk around walking backwards. They only back up when they move for a more dominant horse. So,
well, that's not always 100% true. Like I said, I agree with this concept. Sometimes a horse will back up to show dominance. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Come on. I know my regular viewers got it. The new people will be like, what's he talking about? If a horse turns his butt to you, they will back into you while they're kicking to show aggressive. So when a horse is in fight mode, backing up can be aggressive. But normally, backing up is a show of release of pressure. Normally, from something higher, a horse will back away from something it fears. It will snort. That's not showing dominance. It can be scared. But when we're trying to teach and train a horse, the concept of controlling the horse's feet, whether it's backing up, forward, left, right, whatever, stopping the movement and starting the movement, all those things show control over the feet, and therefore put you in a dominant position, again, in theory.
So, in nature, the one horse that makes the other horse walk backwards is the one in charge. So, by me asking a horse to walk backwards a few steps, makes the horse, if I get the horse to do it, makes the horse see that I'm the leader horse. So they understand it immediately. Come on, back it up.
Yeah, they understand it immediately. Shit, that worked out perfect. Explain that concept again about backing up.
So they understand it immediately. Come on, back it up.
Rick, why are you laughing at her? What I'm laughing at is she is unclear and making this horse make these mistakes, and then she's going to blame the horse. This is not a horse issue. She was not clear. She thinks the horse should know when I snap the rope in front of you to back up, and she hasn't taught it that yet.
And she refuses.
See? It's the horse's fault. The horse refused. The horse is the one that's dominant. Come on, Mia. Shit. How are we going to be boyfriend and girlfriend if you can't communicate with a horse? Rick, why are you? Oh, be quiet, you big crybabies.
The horses that are in control in their natural life don't want to back up for anybody. They're the ones making other horses back up.
So she's demonstrated this three times. A draw and to get the horse to follow her. But she keeps pushing the horse off with bad clues and cues. The horse doesn't understand. This horse isn't mean or dominant. He's confused. He doesn't understand what you want. He's trying. Or she's trying. I don't know if the horse is a mare. I think she called it a mare.
Good girl. That's right.
Oh, she said good girl. Okay, now the horse understands. She said good girl. That'll do it. Horse is like stupid human.
Come on, let's walk. Let's walk. Good.
She kisses when she walks to the horse. She kisses when she walks away.
Girl. Let's walk. Yeah. Now she's beginning to give me a little. Good girl. Submissive. Yeah, yeah.
Whoa! I don't know what's going to happen next, but if this horse was as aggressive and mean as she says, she'd be spitting out hoof dirt right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, she definitely gets that the horse just freaking hit me in the face and disrespected me. So she's going to correct it a little bit, but she uses the whip and noise as the correction. And they cut the tape. Why did they cut it? I don't like this. Why did they cut this tape? Mia, this is not what trainers do. Oh, look. We went from to, oh, I love you. What the hell just happened here? Lost credibility. See, I think she gets aggressive with horses because she's frustrated and she's not communicating with the horse. I'm sorry, Mia, but this is not a horse problem.
What's the story?
You've probably never been told that you had a problem your whole life, but I'm telling you.
Can touch your eyes. Can touch your ears. Your ears are very good. Which means she has a very good trust.
Okay, so let me explain kind of what she said here in a different way. by being able to mess with the eyes and ears, the horse is allowing you. But she's so aggressive. Damn, woman. She's so aggressive with this horse. There's not a kind touch. This isn't kind and understanding. This isn't, you can trust me, I'm not going to hurt you. This is dominatrix. I'm going to grab both ears and pull your head, and I'm going to show you I'm... Come on, people. I don't like pink panty crybabies, but you don't need to be this aggressive with a horse right here.
Yes, I'm very good. Which means she has a very good trust.
This horse has a very good trust. Hey, I want you to watch for the horse's lips here, because this means the horse is learning. Remember? What's the horse learning? Watch your lips.
She has a very good trust.
Oh, look. I saw a lip here. See that lip? Oh, the horse is learning. Rick, she said when the horse licks, he's learning. Come on, people.
The people.
Look at her trying to manhandle. She just stuck her finger in the horse's nose and he pulled away.
Good trust.
Watch this.
People.
Watch this. Stick her finger in her ear. Horse pulls away.
Nose. And let me see the mouth. So this horse hasn't been hit by people because her ears are very good.
Hasn't been hit by people except the part that you cut out when you were swinging a whip and got angry. Maybe then it got hit. So let me explain kind of what she's doing here. Okay, so normally if a horse allows you to do things that is unnatural, it's showing that the horse has accepted it and been desensitized. She's manhandling and forcing this horse to do this, creating frustration, confusion. The horse isn't expecting it and accepting it. It's not a soft... It would be like if I said, hey, this is really good pizza. You want to bite? And I shoved it in this girl's face and said, taste it. Here, smell it. And I shoved it in her nose. And then I said, why don't you like pizza? What's wrong with you? You got a problem with pizza. She's shoving this crap, her stuff on his horse with no softness, sensitivity, understanding. Good grief.
Hasn't been hit by people because her ears are very good.
Oh, she kissed it. That must make it all better. Okay, that's all better.
So she's not afraid because I can touch your ears. So she just don't want to listen to me.
Maybe she doesn't understand what you want. Did you ever consider that might be the problem? No, Rick. The horse doesn't want to listen. That's the problem. Okay. I would just consider maybe I'm not being clear to the horse. Maybe the horse is trying and he doesn't know what I want. No, Rick.
You don't want to respect...
I think this woman has been watching me.
When I'm telling her to stand. Good.
She needs to keep watching because she doesn't have it down.
Girl.
Oh, that almost looked like a little bit of kick there.
When I'm telling her to stand. Good girl.
The horse saw the whip. She's not aware of it. She uses the whip as pressure to move the horse. So when she moves the whip here, the horse is like, oh, she must want me to move. I'll leave. And she says no, but this little stomp right here.
Just don't want to respect me.
Just don't want to respect me. It's the horse's fault. It's not that I made a mistake, I was unclear, and I didn't do it right. The horse doesn't want to respect me. Man, this woman should be like my poster child on how to blame a horse.
She knows what I'm asking for, and she's not giving it to me, so now I'm just going to leave her.
She knows what I'm asking for, but she's just not... So she's come to the conclusion that the horse knows and is actually choosing not to listen to her. I've come to the conclusion she's not clear and doesn't communicate well, and the horse is confused and is trying. See the two different ways that you can look at things?
For a little bit longer. Make her think about it.
What is she thinking about? What are you letting her think about? That you don't know what you're doing? See, she's not changing what she's doing. If you want change in your horse, you have to change first. When you change, your horse changes. When your horse gets better, you got better. Poor little horse is confused. Like,
I can't force this horse to do anything.
Yes, you can force it. if you were clearer, you could absolutely control the horse's feet and teach it. Maybe force isn't a good word.
But I have to make her to choose to cooperate. She's so strong, and she knows it.
So, right here, I'm kind of feeling sorry for this woman that I'm being hard on her. I think this woman wants to do right by the horse. I think she thinks she's doing right by the horse. But what I'm seeing is she's not. So, I don't think she's intentionally being mean. She has been taught to dominate and get aggressive, and that's the only thing she knows, and it's the only tool she has. And so when she sees a horse like this, instead of reflecting on herself and how she could get better, she's convinced that she's right, and therefore projects the horse is wrong, the horse is choosing to be mean, the horse is choosing not to listen. I wish somebody could maybe cut out this one clip to where I don't piss her off. And I tell her that it's you. If you change, your horse will change. I think she wants to do right. I don't think she knows or understands why she's doing wrong.
This thinking process here is all about letting go of the past.
Has nothing to do with the past. This is all emotional BS that women want to put out there, and I'm going to get in touch and zen and all this other crap. I don't care what a horse has been through, and I don't care what his past is, and a horse doesn't care. You think a horse is running around? I wonder if this human was abused. I wonder if this human is religious or not religious. I wonder if this human was mean to a horse before. Horses don't think like that, and neither should people. Horses care about what you do and their position, their comfort seeking, and they resist and move away from pressure. They want to find comfort. They want to understand the rules so they can live a comfortable life without fear or being chased or confusion or frustration. That's what they want. They don't care about their past. They're not looking for a counselor. They're not looking for government programs to save them and give them places to go. They want to know what you know and where their position is. Period. No ifs, ands, buts, or coconuts.
Forgetting it and understanding, it's a whole new start. It's a whole new way of seeing the people that handle her. She has to begin to meet people with respect now. Good girl. And people has to stop fighting with her.
Amen! We finally agree on something! If I was there, I'd grab her and go, yes! Yes! Did you hear what she said? This is critical.
Good girl. And people has to stop fighting with her.
Hey, people need to stop fighting. She doesn't know she's fighting with the horse. Remember what I just said? She doesn't know it. She wants to know it. She kind of understands the concept. She doesn't get it.
Forcing her to do things because she's able to choose it.
I'm telling you, people, I could get the results that she's trying to get. And she's been working with this horse for 9 minutes. I can do it in 8 minutes. What is that? Name that tune. I can do it in 5 notes. I can do it in 8 minutes. I can do it in 7 minutes. I probably could have done it in 5 minutes. Rick, you just think you're good and you know everything. I don't think I'm great and know everything, but I understand horses, and this horse is trying. This horse wants to find, most horses want to find the right answer in an easy way. If the people will only help the horse learn it instead of force it, fight it, and show them who's boss. Oh, she kissed him.
And when
oh,
she does that,
better.
Things becomes easy. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Good
come
girl.
On, baby.
Good girl. Let me get my whip ready, because I'm about to confuse you. See, that's why I said she don't need that damn whip. If she could do this without a whip, why do you need a whip? Okay? I could do this without a whip.
Good girl. That's right.
She's using the whip as a crutch because she's always had it. And if you always do what you've always done, you'll always get what you've always got. So she's always thought that she thinks she needs a whip. It helps. That's what she does. That's her toolbox. And she doesn't realize she doesn't need it. She's good with the kisses.
Good girl.
Good. Okay, day two. Wow. Dude, we're chasing, getting dragged. Oh my god. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Day two. Okay, people. Evidently, this is progress. Now look, I'll give this girl credit. At least she's showing... She thinks she's showing how difficult this horse is. What she's really showing is how she doesn't get it. Man, it sounds like I'm being mean to her, and I'm really not trying to. Look at the way she's got that rope wrapped around her hand in a freaking crazy slip knot twist. Okay, so I'm sorry. This is day two with progress. Help! Let go of the rope! She thinks and has been taught, never give up, show the boss, show the horse who's boss, and don't let go of the rope. Okay, I'll give this girl credit. She's pretty athletic. She knows how to stay her balance. Notice the flowing hair and the lean back.
Second day I work with this mare, and so this is the second day I work with this mare, and
people, I really like this girl. I'm serious. You guys think I hate her and I'm mean to her? I really like her because she's trying so hard. And she thinks she's doing the right thing by this horse. And this poor horse is like, I got some crazy woman thinking she can hang on to this rope.
And she has so much experiences with just breaking through. She has to be trained in having some respect for me as a person.
Mia, I really like you and I feel sorry for you a little bit that I'm being mean to you and I'm trying not to be.
Just stay with me. Because everything in her mind is telling her right now to just take the leadership away from people and just take over the control and just breaking through and running away.
You see how she described that? She totally described what the horse is doing because that's what she sees. And therefore, she's making the horse live up to how she already sees the horse. I see a horse that's confused and wants to try and has never had a good leader. And never had to respect anybody and never found confidence from a human that the horse could trust and follow and not fear or be confused. When you look at a horse, has this a horse problem? You will make it a horse problem and you will never fix yourself. God, come on, Mia. Somebody help this girl and see if she'll watch this. She may watch this. See, women, sometimes women like this take this very to heart, and they actually change. They won't give me credit, and I don't really need the credit or want the credit. They won't say that Rick actually was pretty good and the things he said resonated with me and made me change and now I'm better. And that's all right. They don't need to say that. If it makes it better of a horse, I don't really care. But, and other women take it as, he hates women. He's just mean. He's being abusive. And they want to say that women are right. Women are great. Women are, it's just amazing. The same way they look at a horse with a negative blame, they look at me with negative and blame. When in fact, I'm trying to help you understand a horse. And the horse is trying just to understand what you want from it so it can give it to you. Make the right answer easy instead of fighting and showing it who's boss and blaming the horse. Putting all your human negative emotions on the horse. This horse is stubborn. He wants to run away. He doesn't want to listen to me. He wants to be, show me that he's not the leader. He wants to do. This isn't a horse problem.
But she remembers my training.
The only time she gets to approach this horse is when she traps it. That's not good. She has yet to walk up to this horse in the open to where the horse accepts her coming up. The horse only accepts her walking up when she's trapped.
Easy, girl. Easy.
If this horse was aggressive, she would never get up there. Did the film just cut here?
Easy,
I wonder if this horse threatened
girl.
Or kicked her.
Easy.
Yeah, the horse just switched here. What got cut out here? See, I was going to say,
easy.
She's approaching this horse on a rear that's trapped. That's not in good mood. Horse will hit you with the tail or kick you or turn around and fire and protect it. It's trapped. It's telling you. It's got his butt to you. You're walking to his butt. His head's trapped in a corner and you're approaching it. That's not the way to approach a horse. You approach the horse at the drive line or in the forward area so you can move forward or back of the drive line to control the horse's feet, and she's walking up to the rear to trap it so it can't get away. This isn't smart. Mia, not good. Sorry. I hate to point out another thing that I disagree with.
See, girl. Easy.
Why did that cut out? I'm always suspicious when things get cut out like this, people. Horse is trapped. Has no choice. Horse didn't accept her. Didn't bond with her. It had no choice. She trapped it and forced herself on the horse.
But it has been going very fast. I mean, she's only been trained for one day, except for right now.
This is day two. It was already trained how to do sled bobbing with Mia, the horse trainer, behind me. Rick, why are you being mean to her?
So she's testing my leadership.
She's testing. Maybe you're not the leader. Maybe you're not as good as leader as you think. Maybe your inability to communicate that you are a strong, trustful leader is the problem. No, Rick, it's the horse. Okay.
Can it really be true that humans are more strong than a horse, she thinks, because she has a whole life experience of being the stronger one?
So again, she's projecting this psychology on his horse. She's telling me the horse thinks that because she's done this all the time that she can do this, and it's the horse and it's project. That's not what the horse is thinking. The horse is thinking, I've dragged you around. Without that whip, you ain't shit. You can trap me in a corner and I'll let you. I don't want to fight and kick you. I don't want to bite and stomp on you. So I'm letting you do a lot of things that I'm not comfortable with, that I'm not clear about. I don't trust you, but I'm allowing you to do it only because I don't want to hurt you and I can't run away.
And that's the pattern we have to break to get her to become an easy horse. Yeah.
I like her little crossovers underneath. I think that does kind of get a reaction out of a lot of horses I haven't done, because you go out of their sight and then you appear on the other side. And that will usually spark a response, unless you do it enough to where the horse expects it and goes, ah, it's common for my human to go out of sight and come up. So I don't get spooked when my human pops up out of the blue. That's the purpose of doing that. It allows your horse to understand that it's okay. It allows your horse doesn't tell you no. He knows you can do things out of his sight and you're not going to hurt it. So that can be a trust building exercise. I'm not sure it's as effective as it could be the way she's doing it. Not that she's necessarily doing it wrong. It's just her timing and she gets aggressive, she backs the horse follows her, she shoves her fingers in the horse's nose, she grabs the horse's ear and pulls it down. She's a little aggressive on, she kisses the horse and pets it like she cares, but then she's aggressive when she wants the horse to accept things instead of making it easy for the horse to accept.
To become an easy horse, yeah. Stand. Good girl. She remembers. Very nice.
She slaps a horse a little too much. I slap Buddy a lot because I've desensitized him. But this horse, when you're trying to show your horse that they can trust you and you're soft, I don't want to do aggressive things like slap. I don't want to be aggressive with a horse I'm trying to build trust as a leader with.
Good girl. Good girl. Come on. And stand. And that was good.
Damn, that was a hard slap. Holy crap.
Good.
That sounded like a whip.
That was good. And we walk. Good girl.
Okay, day two of training. She's doing a little desensitizing on the horse by making noise, see if the horse still follow it. I think that's a little advanced for what this horse has done. I don't think this horse is to the point to where she should be doing that yet. But, I mean, you can do it. Some horses will take it, some won't. You can play it off as, hey, the horse did great because I'm a great horse trainer. Or you can just play it off as, you know what, this horse is pretty accepting to crazy shit, and you're lucky you have such a good horse. Look at it either way.
Stand. And I will back you up. See, most people, if we see a nervous reaction with our horses, then we will tell them, oh, it's okay, you want to go look at this thing, and we will be very gentle and soft about it, and feel sorry for them. But horses, they need leadership in order to not be scared. So if our horses get scared, the best thing we can absolutely do for them is to just back them up, tell them, it's not your job to be scared.
I don't agree with that. I don't agree with the way she's saying it. I think you can back a horse up to show that you control his feet and maybe get his attention back on you as the leader. I don't think you back him up to tell him he can't be afraid of something. Horses are prey animals. They're fearful. They're protective. They get insecure. They have to figure out they're safe. New things are going to affect a horse. And if you just back them up as a correction, the more I'm watching her, the more I think she uses a backup as a correction. And a backup shouldn't be a correction. It should be a show that I control your feet. But
it's my job to protect you. So if there's anything to be scared about, I will protect you.
I don't agree with that at all. I'm not telling the horse I protect you. I'm telling the horse, don't be fearful around me because I'm not going to let things hurt you. You're safe with me because I've never let something hurt you, and therefore you feel confident with me, and therefore you don't know. That doesn't mean I won't hurt you. If I run your ass off a cliff and say, see how much this horse trusts me? I can run it off a cliff. That just makes you a shitty person and a shitty leader. A horse doesn't trust you with his life all the time. He may have a bond a little bit. I hear this all the time from women. My horse saved me. My horse jumped. I was falling off and my horse moved underneath me to save me. Horses don't do that. Okay, I'm sorry. You can believe it, but it just doesn't happen.
And you just have to look at me. So if you have a nervous reaction, back it up and follow me. That will make our horses feel safe.
Clicks.
In nature, horses are never frightened. If something frightens the horses...
In nature, horses are never frightened. Is that what she said? Come on, you didn't just say that. I gotta go back, sorry.
In nature, horses are never frightened.
What the hell? Are you kidding me? She just said horses in nature are never frightened? What? There must be a communication problem.
If something frightens the horses, then they will all look up at the leader horse, and only when the leader horse begins to run or flee, then all the horses will.
Absolutely not true. Survival instinct overrides leadership. Okay? Now, if the leader horse takes off because of their herd instinct, most horses will run. But there's no way if the leader horse... I mean, just think about this for a second, people. Listen carefully. What she just described is unless the leader runs, nobody will run. So in her theory, if what she said is true, a lion, tiger, or hunter can walk behind the herd, and as long as the lead horse doesn't see or react, I can just walk up and start tackling horses and chewing on them and eating them. So hunters can, no horses will run from a lion or a tiger or a threat unless the lead horse runs. That's really, really incorrect and a stupid belief. And maybe she doesn't really believe it. She just communicated it wrong. I'm going to cut her some slack here because nobody's going to believe that a horse is going to stand there and let themselves get taken down by a lion because the leader horse didn't run. Are you kidding me? Horse's survival instinct is one.
And that's the exact same thing I want with any horse I'm training. I want the horses, if something scares them, to look up at me. And if I'm not nervous, then they have to stay calm.
Okay, so she got the concept down. Maybe she doesn't have the explanation down. It's true that if you're a good leader and you haven't hurt your horse and you haven't set your horse up to fail and you haven't done stupid things to your horse, if your horse trusts you, he's more willing not to flee when he gets scared. Why? Because you're the leader and you control his feet and he knows that you can stop him from running. So if that is strong enough in the horse's mind that you control his feet, he won't run off from fear and he won't react to fear. So she's got the words down. Either she's not communicating it effectively or she believes wrong. She doesn't get it. I don't know.
Come. And especially this strong mare.
this mare is not that damn strong. This horse is a horse. There ain't nothing wrong with this mare at all. But if I make it seem that it's really strong and it's really difficult and it's really hard and it's really hot, wild, then it makes me look like a better trainer because I was able to get progress with a really strong, hard, wild mare. Maybe. I don't know.
I need for her to definitely not be afraid.
She slaps a damn horse too hard and too aggressive. Come on, people.
Because it's not her natural behavior. It's only something that she does to dominate people.
Okay, so right here, I'm getting a little anxiety. She's going to climb on a freaking horse that she can't control on the ground that's totally disrespecting her already. She's got no saddle, no nothing, nothing to control this horse's head, and she's going to climb on this freaking horse. I think this is a very foolish thing if she gets... I don't know if she does. Shit, I'm at 30 minutes. Come back for part 3 and see if she gets killed by getting on this horse. Because I don't know.